Hello, my name is Jo. I am one of the speech and language therapists within the Southwest Cleft Palate Service. Our team have made a number of videos to help parents support their children's speech sound development at home. This is a short video explaining what input modelling is and how you can try it at home. Input modelling can be used with young children to help increase the number of sounds they use. It can also help children who have speech difficulties who are not ready for direct speech therapy. Input modelling involves the adult making and talking about sounds, but never asking the child to copy and never correcting. Young children will respond more positively when they are not required to copy and there's no risk of failure. Initially they will watch, but they will start to repeat in their own time.
So number one, my tongue's gonna jump. Ready? My tongue's gonna jump.
Try using activities your child is already doing. The focus is on the child watching and listening to you saying the sound. There is no need to ask your child to copy. They will in their own time. Make a sound and pause to see if your child repeats. Your child may repeat the sound immediately, later that day, incorrectly or not at all. If your child repeats the sound correctly, give them praise.
I heard a s at the end. Horse. Keep trying.
By watching the adult make the sound, the child is piecing together a puzzle of how the sound is made. The adult raises objects to her mouth to gain the child's attention to how her mouth makes the sound. The object does not need to match the sound, it is purely used to gain the child's attention. Remember, the focus is on your child looking, not saying the sound. To learn a sound, the child needs to hear the sound several times, so it is best to use these ideas often. Sounds that are useful for your child to hear are p, b, t, d, s, and sh. Try to talk about how the sound is made to help your child learn the sound. You can say them on their own like or in words like puppy. You can say p or a b is a soft sound made by the lips jumping. A t or a d is made at the front of the mouth with the tongue jumping. You can protrude your tongue so your child can see this like t, d. S and sh are long sounds made at the front of the mouth.
My lips jump together and they go.
If your child repeats the sound incorrectly, you can say how you made the sound. For example, I used my lips. I do it quietly. To help your child focus further on how sounds are made, you can play with yogurt in the mirror.
What's on my lips? Look, yogurt, and they're going to jump.
You can also try videoing your sound play and watch it back together. If your child is starting to repeat sounds, but there is air escaping down the nose, you can gently hold your child's nose when they make a sound like this. This may help them produce a sound. This can be useful for children with unrepaired cleft palate or where the palate requires help to seal the nose off. If your child struggles with this, discuss it with your speech and language therapist. Key ideas for input modelling. 1. Repeat sounds often. 2. Sit opposite your child so they can see your mouth. 3. Talk about how sounds are made. 4. Try to use activities your child is already enjoying and find opportunities for input modelling. 5. Try videoing sound play and watch it back together. 6. If they allow, hold your child's nose during sound play.